Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk about why you should not use Google Translate to translate your apps. Okay, so a lot of times I talk about the biggest increase in downloads I've ever had was when I localized my biggest app into like the top 20 languages that were visiting it. And now I saw my downloads triple overnight. It was fantastic, right? And I also talk about the way I went about doing that. I contracted like loads of translation services and they wanted something like $1,000 to do it, right? Which I thought I just didn't have the money to do. And I thought that was ridiculous considering the amount of words that I had. So what I did was I took all the words out of the strings.xml, out of the description, out of, you know, all the text that I was using in the screenshots, everything like that, and I put them into Google Docs, Google Sheets and Google Docs, and I went out onto Upwork and I found translators all over the world. In fact, I did more than 20, and I said, I'll do it for $5 a language, would you be willing to do this amount of words? Right, and I got a lot of people who did it. Some of them may have been 15-year-old kids, but I didn't really care because I didn't need professional translation services. They weren't supposed to be like legal documents or anything like that. But I've talked about this before, right? But and the response to that has always been, there's always been two responses to that. One is, how do you know those people are good enough to be translators? How do you know they're not just saying like swear words in there and everything? And I always say, well, because they're on Upwork and they have reviews and all that, you know, stuff. So, and the other side, they say, why don't you just use Google Translate? And the reason is Google Translate sucks. So let me just read this email I got this weekend from Griffin in the Netherlands. He says, Dear Overpass, I am Griffin from the Netherlands and I really like your YouTube channel, so I decided to take a look at your apps. Ooh. I discovered that the title translation of Ear Spy is not correct. The Dutch, it says Ear Spy, super terechtzitting, sorry. But the word terechtzitting means, in Dutch, means court case. So rather than super hearing, it's saying hearing as a court case. I don't think that's the right translation for the app title. I really enjoy your YouTube videos. Keep up the good work. Okay, so this is kind of embarrassing. And you know what? I don't think this is the first time I heard it. So in that particular occasion, I decided it was just called Ear Spy, and I wanted to add super hearing. So I did that on English, and I didn't want to just take those two little extra keywords and like send them out to all those translators again and wait like 2 weeks for everything to come back. So in that occasion, I did use Google Translate. And this is why Google Translate sucks. It's really good. Google Translate, I mean, I to say it sucks is relative because it is an awesome tool, right? The fact that it does what it does is amazing. But I like to use Google Translate for consuming information rather than producing it. In this case, I thought, you know, oh, this is just a small little thing. I don't really want to do it. You know, and you know, see what happens. This is the kind of stuff that happens. Google Translate, for those of you who don't speak lots of languages and haven't learned different types of languages, most of the time there's not a one-to-one relationship between one word and another, so it's not like an algorithm they could run. The fact that they have all that machine learning and everything in place, and I'm sure Google Translate takes a lot of things from context. So when I type in super hearing, it probably doesn't know what it is I mean to say. So anyway, I just wanted to point that out to you guys. I still highly recommend that if you're going to get your apps translated, just go on to Upwork. So like rather than spend $1,000 to get my app translated, and it wasn't a lot of work, a lot of words at the time, I spent about $100. It was like, or maybe $150. I mean, some languages I couldn't find the right translators for. So like Japanese, Swedish, those ones were, I couldn't find anybody who would do it for $5. It was like $10. Occasionally I would go up to $15. At the time, but you know, and like I said, I didn't need professional translation. I just needed to test it out, right? If it was a legal document, that might be different. So for those of you guys who are thinking about, so I think one of the things is what you should do is make sure that you have all your keywords tight in your natural language, in English, like in my case, and then once you start getting a bit of traction there, at that point, go ahead and get it translated to other languages, because otherwise, every time you want to make one little tweak like I did with this one, you have to go through all those translators. Or you could risk Google Translate. The embarrassing thing about this is I think this is the second time somebody told me this about the Dutch translation. And I just, oh man, I need to fix it. In fact, if anybody out there knows the Dutch for super hearing, like hearing and not the court case, you know, please put it into comments. I'll update the app. Anyway, that is it for today. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. As long as I'm still